Interesting. Tom Foreman, thank you very much. Appreciate that. I want to bring in now Jose Antonio Vargas, the founder and CEO of the media and cultural organization Define America. Jose, good to have you on. Thank you so much. How are you doing?
Doing okay. Thanks for having me on.
Yeah, absolutely. You were at the speech this evening. Overall, what did you think?
He's speechless.
Well,
like the rest of you. Shell-shocked.
I was privileged to be invited, actually, to be at the speech. Leader Pelosi invited me to be one of her guests, so I was there in the chamber.
Nancy Pelosi had him there.
The only time that the president got booed, I don't know if you noticed this, Don, was when he introduced this Victims of Immigration Crime Engagement, which is a whole new office that people can use to report crimes being committed by quote-unquote illegal people. I have to say, by the way, like, are the crimes being committed against American citizens not as, like, I'm, the logic
is shocked
to me, and the fact that this is just so, at its face, discriminatory, right? I think when it comes to immigration,
racist.
Clearly this president is not operating in a factual kind of environment.
Do you think,
right now, Don Lemon has been keeping his mouth shut after Trump's speech, his State of Union speech, and all the left, they're all just shell-shocked. They don't know what to say. Looks like since the speech, CNN's been kissing up to Trump. They were trying to extend an olive branch.
You think that because, you know, his rhetoric was different, his language wasn't quite as harsh. He's you know, go on.
Well, look at, you know, at Define American, we like to do, you know, we like to make sure that we're sparking conversations. So I'm curious what he means when he says that he's looking for both Republicans and Democrats to work on immigration reform. He's right. President is right that we have not had meaningful immigration reform in decades. But it's really tough to kind of, you know, have a series of raids and start deporting mothers of U.S. citizen children like last week and then this week. Talk about immigration reform.
Well, they've been doing that for a long time.
Let's listen to a bit of what he said, and then we'll talk more.
By finally enforcing our immigration laws, we will raise wages, help the unemployed, save billions and billions of dollars, and make our communities safer for everyone.
What do you think, Jose?
Well, Don, let me make this absolutely clear. There is no correlation between being here as an undocumented person and committing crime. The study after study has shown that there's no correlation whatsoever, right? And what I found interesting is that the president and Republicans believe in smaller government, yet they keep trying to spend billions and billions of dollars trying to protect you from quote-unquote criminals from Mexico, when the reality is
Don Lemon's going to destroy
them
in a second.
From Mexico to the United States. You know, the fastest growing undocumented population, Don, are Asian people. I'm Filipino, right? Mm-hmm. We're the
Filipino.
Fastest growing undocumented population, not Mexicans and not Latinos.
The president also spoke about building his wall. Listen to this.
And we will soon begin the construction of a great, great wall along our southern border.
USA, USA, USA.
As we speak tonight, we are removing gang members, drug dealers, and criminals that threaten our communities and prey on our very innocent citizens.
From all walks of
bad
life.
Bad ones are going out as I speak, and as I promised throughout the campaign. To any in Congress who do not believe we should enforce our laws, I would ask you this one question. What would you say to the American family that loses their jobs, their income, or their loved one because America refused to uphold its laws and defend its borders?
Jose, what do you think?
That's a globalism.
Well, what I think is, in this country, I think we know that laws haven't always meant just and justice. Right?
All right.
I mean, actually, tonight, I met the two U.S. citizen children
Philippine
of a woman named Guadalupe, who got deported to Mexico. She's been living here since she was 14. She got deported because, you know, her crime, so to speak, was providing for her kids. She got a fake social security number, which is what I had to do, so I could, you know, keep working and paying social security and paying taxes.
He just admitted to breaking the law, committing identity theft and fraud and perjury, you know.
I have to ask, by the way, How many more billions of dollars do we want
to... No, wait, he has to ask, by the way, and change the subject real quick, because, oh, dang, he just admitted on air to breaking the law. And he was sitting there, invited, sitting there with Nancy Pelosi next to her.
And protecting you from this border. Has humanity ever built a border that could withstand human will? So long as parents are hungry and want to feed their kids, they're going to cross every border you put in front of them. Now, as I said, I was in the chamber tonight, and I'm looking at all those congressional members and reminding myself about their own immigrant backgrounds.
I want to ask you, because I saw the story that you mentioned about the woman who got a fake Social Security card. By presenting that woman and her story, do you think you're making an argument for the other side? Because there are many people who say, you know, and believe she broke the law. And if she broke the law, she has to face the consequences. If you, that is a federal crime to have a fake Social Security card.
Well, by the way, and, you know, since we are talking about that, right?
Yeah, we're talking about that, right? It is a crime. Don Lemon decided he wants to stand up and show that he actually knows how to report, like a reporter, instead of just being a political hack.
Maybe we should talk to the Social Security Administration, who collect contributions from people like
it's
me.
It's their fault.
Who use fake.
Because you'll sign up
when that happens,
illegally.
I don't want to have to use fake anything. I used to fake Social Security number so I could work. And I could pay Social Security so I could pay taxes, right? What happens?
So he's an illegal alien.
I used to fake Social Security number so I could work, and I could pay Social Security so I could pay taxes.
He's admitting to committing
crimes. We are caught in a system that doesn't make any sense.
Real crimes.
People like me don't enjoy being here and being called criminals and, you know, quote unquote, illegal people, right? We all do what we do to survive. Now, mind you, by the way, being here illegally is a civil offense, not a criminal one. So is her crime because she's providing for her children?
Yeah, now he's deflecting. You know, he's trying to say, well, it's just civil across the border, but that's not what we're talking about. They commit various other crimes, like you admitted to, you know, identity theft.
Crime is a federal offense. I mean, to have a Social Security card, that's pretty serious.
Yeah, no, that's pretty serious.
Again, that's something that I had done myself. What are we supposed to do?
Just admit it on national TV.
If you want to work and contribute.
I'm just going to play devil's advocate. People would say that.
Finally, he's going to play devil's advocate.
In many instances, people come across the border, or children come across, their parents brought them across, and it's not their fault.
All that, yes.
But it was her choice to come across the border. And people would say, if you don't come across, you don't break a crime, you don't commit a crime,
well, actually,
therefore you don't go to jail or you don't get deported.
Well, but got it.
Being here...
Don Lemon's got it. He's still shell-shocked, though, after that Trump speech. He's like, oh, man. You know, if he starts acting more like this instead of like a political hack, then maybe the President of the United States wouldn't be calling him very fake news.
Being here illegally, unlawfully, is a civil offense and not a criminal one. Oh. So that's
straw man arguing.
It's still breaking the law, whether it's civil or...
And again, but why are people coming? I mean, we put a sign out to the U.S.-Mexico border that says, keep out 10 yards in. What do we say? Help wanted. We are a country addicted to cheap labor. We've always been addicted to cheap labor, right? I mean, right now, as we're talking, 1.8 million undocumented people in the state of Texas, right? How are they getting around? I mean, is there a subway system in Texas? So people...
No, they're committing other crimes.
...have to drive without a license. Yeah. And before you know it, they get arrested. Before you know it, they get deported.
Good.
Before you know it, they're separated from their family.
Oh, well.
So what is the crime there in trying to work? I mean, I think one of the things that was
but isn't the actual crime coming across the border?
Being here illegally.
No, there's a bunch of crimes there. You know, driving without a license, without insurance, identity theft, fraud, perjury on federal documents.
Civil offense, not a criminal one.